Earth had not known worldwide peace, nor any lasting one in its history. For war and indifference is a defining trait of the human race. Wars may have been fought differently, but the results are always the same. It all started on November 28, 2345. A mysterious fracture in space was discovered. But as mysterious as it appeared, it vanished 2 weeks later before top minds on Earth could study the anomaly. January 18, 2426, the date known to be the beginning of what would become the greatest loss of life in history. Six of the greatest countries on Earth waged war on each other in response to a warning of an imminent and simultaneous attack. The so-called intel could not be verified by the surviving commanders, but regardless, the war was expected. To some, this gave the impression that this was a premeditated war. In just the first year of the war, nearly half of the human population has been eradicated. Crucial parts of civilization have been crippled by the attacks. Hospitals in ruins, communications have been limited, and even halting the production of food. The loss of life from disease and starvation is as many as the lives lost from their weapons. March 16, 2444. Nearly a century after the fracture in space appeared, the mysterious phenomena reveals itself once again. In the midst of an ongoing war, this time, scientists sent out probes to study the strange phenomena. Classified as a wormhole, they believe that one day it will aid humans in space exploration. However, once again the wormhole disappears, but not without obliterating Pluto as it vanished. The news of Pluto's destruction caused widespread panic. It also left scientists asking, what force could possibly destroy an entire planet? But for the scientists, panic was the least of their concern. The wormhole may have closed, but they learned that our planet was scanned. They fear that someone, or something, is watching Earth. December 19, 2444. After 18 years of bloodshed and billions of lives lost, the war has finally ended. But not because people realize the futility of war, but because scientists have made the existence of the wormhole public. One thing has been made clear. Differences needed to be set aside if humanity is to survive the days to come. With the rise of an unknown threat, people of Earth have come to realize there's a greater danger to us than each other. May 13, 2445. Several nations signed a treaty promising to lay down all arms and vow to work together for the good of mankind. Decades later, borders fell and governments have merged. Once, there had been hundreds of separate countries and governments. Then, nations were united. One planet, one people, all under one banner, the banner of the Terran Republic. People have come together and made Earth a paradise, even without leaving the planet. With advancements in technology, medicine, agriculture, and aerospace, there was no doubt that the formation of the Terran Republic was a massive success. For the first time in a long time, there was peace. July 3, 2542. Like its second appearance or after 98 years, the wormhole resurfaced for the third time. The defenses of Earth were ready for anything, but the probes have not detected any threat nor any scans unlike before. It was believed that the scan detected nearly a century ago was feedback from the very probes that were sent to investigate the wormhole. The scientists have then theorized, maybe Earth was never in any danger. Weeks later, and as expected, the wormhole closes once again. Without a common threat nor a reason to work together, some were worried that Earth and its people would go back to its old ways. But this wasn't the case. Earth and everyone on it had lived in prosperity since the formation of the Terran Republic. There was an abundance in resources, therefore, there was no reason for war. For millions of years, Earth was the only home for us humans, but that was about to change in the years to come after the year 2582. Our solar system was set to be explored with a mission to terraform known and unknown worlds, including their moons. One famously terraformed moon is Phobos, one of Mars's moons. What was once a dead and barren rock orbiting Mars became a sanctuary teeming with life with its peaceful parks and raging rivers. Eventually, the thought of discovery had filled the imagination of people. Hence, the quest for adventure and exploration has truly begun, and so does the story of Thomas or Tom Connery. The year is 2615. Nearing the edge of our solar system, the Moon Belt, a less asteroid-filled section of the Kuiper Belt, was discovered by Tom Connery. There, he also found what seems to be the remains of Pluto, which was destroyed over 170 years ago. there were rumors of clues to possible alien life within the large fragments of the debris, but Connery neither confirmed nor denied these rumors. Regardless, people believed that if it did exist, Connery would be the first to find it. May 2618. Martin Harris, the Terran Republic's vice president, died from a heart attack. With a few months left in the VP's term, TR's president, Sylvia Wyatt, wanted Connery to take the position for the remainder of her term. Connery was known to love exploration, so to people's surprise, he accepted the desk job. November 10, 2618. After President Sylvia Wyatt's term ended, Tom Connery ran for the Terran Republic's presidency and won near unanimously. Connery served 12 years or 4 3-year terms as TR's president and later retired in January 2630 with the intention of returning to the moon belt and continue his exploration. February 14, 2630. An organization called Business Forward, with CEOs of top corporations as its members, held a meeting and agreed to keep tabs on Tom Connery's activities. June 28, 2630. According to Terence Matherson, a high-ranking member of Business Forward, Connery's 12 years of presidency was only a means to get what he needs for his return to the moon belt. Matherson claimed that Connery indeed found evidence of alien life, and it is Business Forward's interest to support Connery, for they will benefit from such important and historical discovery. July 2630. Other members of Business Forward knew for a fact that Connery would not accept assistance from them. Geraldo Perez, another member, believes that the TR is taking them to a different direction because the time of war is long gone and there's no need for a strict government to be in control. Perez proposes that their group, Business Forward, should aim for freedom and move into politics to get the government out of their businesses and their lives. Still uncertain of opposing the TR, Matherson proposes that should they do this, businesses, unions, and even mercenaries will be part of their new faction. While some saw this as an opportunity to get TR's strict policies out of their way, some members saw this chance to add more zeros to their bank accounts. And on July 30, 2630, with all Business Forward members in agreement, the new conglomerate was born. February 18, 2631. Henry Briggs, a 27-year-old brilliant xenobiologist, was struggling to get a job in his field. Despite his brilliance, he has a tendency to make people around him nervous, making working with him a near impossible task. Therefore, well-known companies would not even offer him a job. Growing up with Asperger's syndrome, Briggs had no social skills, making human interaction a challenge for him. To make ends meet, Henry Briggs took on other work outside his expertise. Waxing cars, washing dishes, and even telemarketing. He was willing to swallow his pride if it meant he would not live with his parents. One day, a well-dressed woman reached out to Briggs offering him a dog-sitting job. Briggs didn't exactly have good experience with dogs growing up. Remembering his younger days, he quickly ignored the woman. March 4, 2631. The same well-dressed woman once again reached out to Briggs. Unemployed and desperate, he accepted the job offer when traveling was mentioned. Briggs later learned that the dogs belonged to TR's former president, Tom Connery. It was subtle and discreet, but Connery successfully hired xenobiologist Briggs for his second trip to the moonbelt as a dog sitter. Connery was a politician, and Briggs thought little of politicians, but his achievements as an explorer is reason enough for Briggs to accept him. September 2632. Connery's expedition reached the moonbelt after 15 months. In another three, they found a half a mile long and 1,500 foot wide fragment. To other explorers, the fragments look ordinary and nothing special, just like the others they found, but Connery thought otherwise. During Connery's first expedition to the moon belt, a high-frequency signal with a steady rhythmic pattern was detected. With new equipment, they were able to pinpoint the source of the signal, and Briggs later found a small figurine that was anything but human. He didn't mean to touch the figurine, but Briggs felt compelled by an unknown force to do so. He hasn't been the same since touching the statue. He's had a series of visions and been going in and out of trance on multiple occasions. As time went on, Briggs noticed the changes within him. The visions had stopped, but since then, he felt that he belonged elsewhere, like he had a different purpose. One thing he can remember from his visions is one word: Vanu. Like-minded scientists like Briggs often get together during breaks for a quick chat. Without realizing, they had formed the very foundation of a new faction. Over the course of more than two centuries, the ideals of Vanu had gained popularity and significantly gained more followers. Although just like Briggs, it was revealed that some of them received and continue to receive telepathic feedback from the near-extinct alien civilization. Their leader, Willis Scott, announced that their group will remain neutral no more, and any faction that opposes the views of the Vanu will be considered an enemy. And on June 21, 2845, Scott declared independence for their faction, and thus the Vanu sovereignty arises.
Hello everyone, I hope you enjoyed that one as much as I enjoyed making it. If you do, be a good lad and hit subscribe. There's actually more to this, but you know, I only wanted to cover how the factions were formed. If you want me to get into the other stuff, let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching, and as always, stay awesome, Possum.